You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Today's podcast is brought to you by OSV Kids, a magazine designed to help children grow in their faith throughout the liturgical year. To find out more, head to osvkids.com. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Monday, July 12th, 2021. Now, this week we are starting in on the second Beatitude as we work our way through all of them. Last week we did Blessed Are the Poor in Spirit, and this week we are doing Blessed Are Those Who Mourn, for they will be comforted. Now, just to review, the eight Beatitudes were shared by Jesus Christ himself when people followed him, hanging on his every word, and when he gave a very important sermon. We call it the Sermon on the Mount. And as we look at the Beatitudes, we realize that they show us how to be holy, how to be blessed, but also how to be happy. And all eight of them come together to give us a portrait of who Christ was. And we will only be happy if we model our lives after him. So let's talk about this. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Now, when I was a child and I first heard this beatitude, I thought it was sort of odd. How can you be both happy or blessed and crying at the same time? Oh, then when I thought about it more, I thought, well, I guess only people that are really sad are holy. Now, both of these childish thoughts that I had miss the point. So there are several important things that we can reflect on and draw from this. Even if we aren't going through a particularly sad part of life right now, this beatitude is important for all of us. So the first thing that I want you to understand when you read this beatitude is that Jesus always sees your hurts, your pains, and your struggles. He always sees them and he understands how you feel, and he will always be with you, offering you his comfort. So that is the first thing we need to believe, right? Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. And even when the whole world disappoints you, even when your family doesn't understand you, we can rest assured that Christ is still there with us, comforting us. So that is the first thing to understand. Now, it's not only good news, it's also a challenge for us. Because a lot of times when we are suffering or we are sad, we don't look to Jesus for comfort. We say, oh, I can take care of this myself, or why aren't these people in my life keep making me happy and understanding me? They're so disappointing. Or we turn to something else that will just give us temporary comfort, like distracting ourselves by watching a movie or scrolling on social media or eating way too much chocolate, right? We don't look to Jesus for comfort. We ignore him. We take the pain that we are in and we try to just deal with it ourselves. But Christ is saying, you will only be happy if when you are sad, when something really bad has happened in your life, if you surrender and you look to me for comfort. Christ alone has the comfort that you need. Yes, he put great people in your life that will show you his love, but ultimately, it is him, Jesus alone, that has the comfort that you need. And so, Sprouts, we are going to have the same type of challenge each day that we had last week, where we reflect on this verse from the gospel. This week, we are reflecting on Matthew chapter 5, verse 4, for the second of the Beatitudes. So I'll say it, and then if you would simply just repeat it. And as you do, think about what we talked about today, the fact that when you are suffering or sad or mourning, don't try to deal with it yourself. You will only be happy if you turn for comfort to Jesus. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Just one more thing. If you are looking for a good boredom buster or preschool prep for the fall, we have put together the ABCs of the Catholic Faith coloring pages. It is a downloadable set that is 100% free. You can find the direct link to download this set and use them right away in the notes for this podcast episode.
This show is a production of the Spoke Street Media Podcast Network. For more great podcasts, visit SpokeStreet.com.